Hi, I'm Katie Couric. That's a lie. I'm lying. I am Diane Sawyer. What? No, I'm lying again. I am Kathy Najimy, and I am here today because last year I met a woman, a mom, who actually changed my life. Actually, not true again. Lying again. The very first time that I saw her was on one of the very first makeup infomercials ever. I was transfixed. She was funny, she was glamorous, she was well-spoken and thoughtful, and she was eye-lined to the T. Beautiful. And her name is Victoria Jackson. Hi, Victoria.
Hey, Kathy.
Now I know you as a great friend and to me and our sister circle of women that you brought together, but most remarkably, as one of the most inspiring, miraculous, dedicated moms that I have ever met. You have a daughter. She's 17 now, Allie.
Yes.
I have met her. She's gorgeous and she kicks ass at Boggle. And what happened when she was 14, 15 years old?
You know, all of a sudden, literally, we were on a family vacation. She's about 14 and a half. And we come back, we're in the car, and we're sitting there, and she says, you know, Mom, I kind of have this eyeball headache. And I feel like I have a headache, but it feels different. There's something wrong. And actually, things are starting to get blurry. So I go to the doctor. He basically examined my daughter, who now her vision is getting worse and worse.
And you're probably freaking out.
And I'm freaking out. Now she's still having the eye pain. She's literally almost becoming now blind in the one eye. Mm. And we get the results back from the blood test, and it says positive for NMO. And all I hear next is the doctor who originally sent me to the neurologist says, you know what, your daughter has NMO, which is neuromyelitis optica. She's probably going to be potentially gone in the next 4 years. She's going to be, you know, quadriplegic, blind, paralyzed, because NMO, neuromyelitis optica, attacks the optic nerve, which results in blindness, right, and the spinal cord, which results in paralysis. Mm-hmm. And it's sort of like your body is attacking itself and eating away at the myelin sheath, which protects all the nerves. And it was just, that was, you know, the game changer right there. That was when it all just changed forever.
What is the progress? You talked about how when she was 14, she didn't really know about it, and then later on when you started getting your foundation together and meeting with the doctors and getting a few answers and piecing together a puzzle that was giving you some awareness of what was happening, what's the change like? What is she now more into it? Does she want to know? What's her reaction to it? Tell me about like her day is like for her.
There's been this extraordinary sort of metamorphosis of Allie, you know, where we started with when she wasn't sure what was going on and she'd be watching Mystery Diagnosis on TV going, I think I have Reiter's syndrome, to not wanting to know, to now not wanting to still be the poster child of NMO.
Right.
She doesn't want sympathy. She wants to be the girl who's going now through her last year of school, who wants to be the captain of the tennis team, the editor-in-chief, who has gotten the straight A's in school. But she looks at it like, you know what, NMO isn't going to define me. It's a lifestyle, Mom. Mm-hmm. It's like a condition, it's a thing I have, but like I'm still gonna live my life. Mm-hmm. And I know it's hard on her. You know, you can't still not wonder, as she said when she first found out, when she saw some papers, on my desk that said NMO, and she said, is that what I have? What's NMO? And then we sat down and started to talk about it, and she went to her doctors and said, I want to know, you know, how long do I have? Like, how long do I have before I'm going to be blind and paralyzed? Like, I need to know. Mm. And the doctor said, you know, Allie, hopefully that's not going to happen, but the answer is we don't know. Mm. And I can see still now in Allie the girl who's going to do it all. She's cramming it all in. You know, she wants to do whatever it is she's going to do. She's just full on doing it. Because I know there has to be that part of her that, well, what if I won't be able to ever play tennis again? What if I won't be able to do that?
Mm-hmm. And she's, you know, it's so hard to be a teenage girl, just to be.
Yeah.
And so she's carrying on with her life, because I have met her and she's fantastic and funny and great. And I see her carrying on with her life and knowing that there's this thing looming, but it hasn't seemed like it has stopped her. It doesn't seem like someone who's given up. So she has your strength, like whatever perseverance that you have, that crazy, miraculous thing, it seems like she has it too, because now she's even speaking out about it, right?
She's speaking out about it. You know, we're being honored, and she's like, why are they honoring me? You know, and you know, I said, Allie, because for a lot of people, you're an inspiration that you are dealing with what you're dealing with, and you're doing your thing, and you're living your life, and you know, it's really bonded the two of us together in it, where normally at this age, mother, daughter, going through their teen angst and everything else, you know, we're sort of joined at the hip on this. And as she turned to me and said, you know what, Mom, this isn't just about you and I anymore. This is about something much bigger, isn't it? And I said, yeah, Allie, I guess it is. Neither one of us signed up for it. You know, we didn't want it, but yeah, it's probably not just about just you and I anymore.